Thanks for having me here.
No, thank you for coming.
I just want to play a devil's advocate to you. Because I think, you know, what is happening in our classrooms is, the amazing thing about India is that we don't have these benchmarks. We don't have somebody coming and telling us, you have to do this, you don't have to do that. You don't have NCERT or anybody coming in till class 8, which gives teachers the autonomy to do what they want with their children. Whether we use that autonomy, we don't use autonomy, that's a different thing. But most teachers have that space, and most good teachers are using that space. And we have amazingly good teachers in our country who are using that space. Now, when we look at what you had said earlier about what is it that the child remembers, and what is it that feeds into the growth of the child, the development of the child, from being young citizens to being somebody who is contributing as a responsible citizen of the country, I think it's a long journey. But when you look at how much time does a child have, 30 weeks in any class, right? 30 weeks is all they have in any class. And you can see the growth happening from the time they step into the class in class one and the way they grow and they come out of that class. What happens during that time? How much of learning is happening within the classroom? How much is happening outside? That was a question that you had touched on. And I think if when teachers and when we look at the material that's going into the classroom, because we can't do away with the textbooks, unfortunately, we need to have that framework with us. It is the bulwark which will be in place for maybe the next few years. Maybe it will change after that. For the next few years, you have the textbook. How do we use that textbook? How do we go beyond the textbook? How do we go behind the text, behind the word? If teachers can do that, and in this, I would like to mention just one other point before I close, is the kind of textbooks that are coming in. When, for instance, we look at maths or science, it seems to be universal. When we look at language, when you look at English, and I look at the kind of textbooks that we normally give to our children, it's all still coming from, you know, outside. It's coming from English, from England, basically, from British texts. And they're all the texts that we studied. I mean, I studied Southey, and I studied Keats and Wordsworth, and we are giving the same things to our children. Is there a need for that to change? This thing of learning beyond academics, will that be more relevant for the child if we say that this is a text that the child will enjoy, the child identifies with, there is a relevance of that text that the child is reading with what is happening in her life? Thank you.